sunny day here in India today, and so I thought I'd do a nice romantic reading for you guys and a little pep in the day because it's Monday and I'm sure you guys are all at work, and so let's see something a little light. Okay, so today's topic is what is your next relationship, romantic relationship, going to be like? What is coming up? Your next love connection, right? So we have three piles in front of you, pile 1, 2 and 3. Pile 1 is the moonstone. Pile 2 is the amethyst. And pile 3 is the citrine, right? So guys, please pause your videos and pick your pile. What is the next connection? What is the next romantic relationship coming your way? Right, so let us start with pile 1. Okay, so pile 1 with the moonstone. What is the next connection coming your way? Oracle number 33, C, no, B. Okay. From the tarot, we have strength, 7 of wands. Mm-hmm. Exchanging gifts, deep diver. I hope you can see these cards, guys. And last is unbound. Okay. Mm-hmm. Right, just give me a minute so I can assimilate this. Okay guys, so the first thing that I'm getting for you guys in this connection is the next connection that is coming to you, romantic one. I think with this oracle card, I feel you guys are going to somehow intuitively know about it, okay? You are going to be knowing about it intuitively. There is a sense here, because this card says oracle, so there is a sense here that you know, you might be in a very empowered state of mind, very intuitive, very awakened state of mind. I'm seeing, you know, like the throat and the heart chakras are lit as well as the crown, right? So maybe you guys are very intuitive people, or maybe just, you know, you would intuitively know, you know, that there is this connection coming, right? And it's the number 3 plus 3, which is 6. You know, so this is about love. You will know that, you know, there is someone coming before this happens. All right. Now, coming to what kind of a connection it is, I really feel that it's going to be a very deep connection, guys. All right. With the strength card here and the deep diver card here, okay, this is like heavyweight stuff, okay? It's not a fly-by-night connection. It is a pretty intense connection, all right? And I'm also pairing up the unbound card here, which is like the judgment, all right? This connection is something that is going to make you dive deep, deep, deep into your emotions, all right? This person triggers a very strong awakening in you and a very strong surge of feelings and emotions and passion within you. All right. I'm seeing that, you know, this is something like, you know, I don't know, like it says deep diver, diving into a task. So it's almost like, you know, you want to, you know, invest a lot in this connection. I also feel with this unbound card here, releasing soul patterns, contracts, past lives, I feel that you would be, you know, like you would either be going through or would go through some sort of an awakening when this person comes. It might be very abrupt, very sudden and unexpected. Your meeting with this person could be very sudden and unexpected. All right. It's going to be like just one fine day, you know, you have an intuition about it. Yes. But I feel just one fine day you guys are going to meet up. All right. It's going to be that sudden. There is also a sense of, you know, like past lives here. When I see releasing soul patterns, contracts and past lives, this is a person who's like a soulmate. They have come, you know, to give you this connection. And it is going to definitely make you dive deep within yourself, within your emotions and within this connection. And this is going to be a very strong connection, guys. Okay, no matter what the final result of this connection is, it is a very strong connection and it is also a very balanced connection. This is equal give and take, right? There's also the color pink here, you know, so I'm seeing that, you know, there's a lot of love here, guys. With this deep diver and this exchanging gifts, the love is going to be equal for both of you, from both of your sides. It's going to be deep. This is a number 9, this is a number 10. So it's like, you know, you guys are going to be in balance. You guys are going to go very deep in this. And it is going to start suddenly. All right. You will have some sort of an intuition about it before you go ahead. You know, or someone might even tell you that this is what's going to happen or something like that. And it happens to you. Okay. Now, what I'm seeing here with the 7 of staves, okay, the 7 of wands rather, is that either you or they might resist this connection initially, all right, when it happens. Because, you know, it's like very intense, right? It's a very intense connection. So it is possible that you, either you or they might be resistant to this connection initially. But as time passes by, as you gain balance in this connection, then it is going to start, you know, becoming deeper and deeper and deeper, okay? There is a sense of one of you being resistant to this connection initially, all right? Because maybe there are certain fears you have, maybe you see the other person in a different light, and you know, a certain light. And I am seeing differences. I'm seeing that both of you are going to be very different, guys. Okay, I mean, like here I have a man and a dragon, here I have a woman and a cat. So there is some difference here that you guys are going to have differences between you. But those differences trigger you to go deep within, guys. It's going to be a very emotional connection. It's going to be a very emotional connection, all right? Now, when I see the strength card here, I am seeing that this person, whoever is coming in your life, is going to be a very big support to you, all right? They are going to be like, you know, this man holding this woman, or even if you look at the woman, you know, she's stalwart, she's not letting go of him. So no matter what kind of circumstances you guys go through in this connection, this relationship is not going anywhere. I mean, even if you guys sort of take breaks or end up as friends or something, this relationship is not going to go away anywhere, because the bond is strong, very strong. It's the strength card, it's a number 8. So it's not going anywhere. Whatever be the case in this connection, I do sense that there are balance issues here. There will be balance issues, because there is this resistance here, there is this clearing of you know, past karma and things like that. That is there, but there is something about you guys, once you are in balance, once you know, you dive deep and remove all these blockages that you've been holding on to, then this connection unfurls in the right way, in the best way possible. It's a very intense connection, guys. I'm getting that it's a very intense connection. It is something that will also trigger your awakening, your transformation, right? You could, you know, get some sort of intuitive psychic powers because of this connection. You know, I don't know, maybe you guys have some sort of telepathic connection here, you know, because of this intensity. And this is also a soulmate. This is someone coming back from the past with whom you have had ties for maybe past lifetimes also. I mean, you might know this person, but mostly I'm getting like past life vibes here. All right. I do sense that you or they will have to work, all right, or fight for either for your independence here or for the connection, depending on how the circumstances are. There needs to be grit. That's what I'm hearing. There needs to be some sort of grit to be in this connection, because it's going to be very intense, guys. I'm getting a lot of intensity, depth, and like, you know, I'm also getting that there might be shakeups here, you know, because when I see this card here, it says unbound, releasing soul patterns. Any soul pattern, that any releasing of any sorts is very triggering, okay? It's, you need to release to come into balance. So any kind of releasing of anything, it's like, you know, it's not easy, all right? Because you have to dive deep. It's like a task, like it says, diving into a task. So this is going to require a lot of work from you guys. This is not a very light connection. It's intense, but it's also very deep and very fulfilling. If you plan to go with it, if you plan to work on yourself, it's something amazing. It will unbound your soul, you know. It will set your soul free from any kind of limitations, any kind of conditionings, right? And make you be, you know, as it says, see, know, be. You will be your true, genuine self because of this connection. Now, it's going to be a triggering one, like I said, okay? Because it's very intense, guys, right? It says releasing soul patterns, contracts, and past lives. So, yes, I mean, you know, this is about you kind of freeing yourself from any conditionings or patterns or contracts. Maybe this connection that is coming to you is of a soul contract, okay, and you are meant to sort of live out certain things with each other, so that, you know, you release and you become who you are, right? So this is something intense, guys, right? This is really intense. In terms of the person that you are meeting, I feel this person's a very deep person. They are a very deep person. I think this person has gone through a lot of shakeups themselves, and they might either be in the process of or have already removed all the masks and layers and become this oracle, this person who is genuine and authentic. This is also a person who's very strong, who sticks by you, okay, in thick and thin. They are generous with this exchanging gifts. They're generous with their money, with their time, with their emotions, with gifts. This might be a person who gives you flowers or chocolates or takes you out or something like that. But, you know, it's only when this person, I'm getting like, you know, initially this person might be resisting, all right? You might feel that this person is kind of trying to push you away or something like that. But, you know, all of a sudden this person is going to have a realization and then dive deep into this connection, all right? So maybe there's a bit of a runner dynamic here with this person, because once this person actually gets into a connection, they're all for it, they're all in, right? That's what I'm hearing. This person is not someone, you know, who is shallow by any means. This is a very deep person. I mean, the zodiac signs I'm getting from this are water signs mainly, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. With the judgment card here, I'm getting I'm not really sure what sign rules the judgment, but I'm getting, again, like Scorpio vibes here. With the strength, I'm getting Leo, but the zodiacs don't matter in any case. This person is someone who is very deep, and once they commit, they go all out to make this connection something beautiful. With this contract thing also, I feel that maybe some of you might be breaking out of previous connections, or they might be breaking out of previous connections which were not serving you or suiting you and were karmic in nature. So maybe that might be the reason why either of you might have been a little blocked off, okay? But this connection, requires some sort of cleaning and cleansing before you get into it. So if you are not going to do your work, if you don't want a connection with work, then obviously, you can always choose to walk away from it. But this is a connection. If the required work is put in here, guys, then this is something that is very transformative, very deep and very intense. And it is something that lasts for a long time, for even lifetimes, I'm hearing. But it requires you to shed, it requires you to shed a lot of conditionings. This is definitely coming up for you guys somehow, okay? This person is very genuine, very deep, very intense, and also very generous. They might also have a tendency to kind of, surprise you, well, good and bad. sometimes they might be a little too intense and, surprise you, or sometimes they might balance. When they're more in balance, they're better. But this is a person who is not here just for the fun of it. Okay, so this is your next connection, guys. This is why it's coming. The reason why it's coming is because it's, supposed to transform you. The kind of person you're meeting up with is someone very intense and very solid and very, deep, right? And the connection itself is something that will last a long time if you are ready to put in the work and balance yourself and be genuine and authentic. And it is going to happen suddenly, I sense. It's not something that's going to be slow and steady. You're going to probably meet this person suddenly, because you see a jack in the box here and then we see the unbound. This is going to be a sudden meeting up with this person, all right? And then the connection itself proceeds with very rapid speed, I feel, if you both are in it. So this is what I'm getting for your next connection, pile one. So let's go to pile two. So pile two is the amethyst. Athena, your superheroic odyssey is admired. Six of cups. Three of swords. A tidy house, clarity and organization. Unfinished symphony. And star seed. Interesting cards, guys. So what's coming up? What's your next connection like? Pile number two. First of all, I'm getting drawn to the Six of Cups, right? This is a definite soulmate. This is probably a twin flame soulmate, divine counterpart, someone you have shared like many, many lifetimes with, someone with whom you have a very romantic bond. I'm sensing this next connection of yours, pile two, is going to be very romantic. All right. Just look at the amount of roses that are there. There is a forest here. There's a lady and lord here. I mean, there is an old world charm here that I'm seeing. Aragorn and Arwen kind of thing here. Or, Lancelot and Guinevere. I don't know how to pronounce it exactly, but that's the kind of Arthur, right? I'm getting that kind of vibe here. So this is a very romantic and very elegant sort of connection that's coming up for you guys. Wow. And it's a reconnection. For some of you, it could be somebody like with the unfinished symphony here. Maybe this could be someone from your past, maybe with someone, this might be someone you have had some sort of an unfinished business with, or this could be someone whom you've known in past lives, and the connection couldn't really unfold, right? So now this person is coming back around to finish this symphony, is what I'm getting. All right, now I feel that before you meet this person, you might be like, you know, in this mode of this three of arrows thing, all right? You might be basically like, you know, a little heartbroken. Some of you might be a little heartbroken, might be feeling that love is not worth it, and maybe you might have had some sort of problem, you know, in terms of connections in the past. Maybe you just were sitting there, you know, like just, you know, the sea is so stormy, there's lightning here, she's so upset and she's looking at the heart. So yeah, I mean, perhaps this is the mode that you might be in, you know, before you meet this person. But I do sense that, you know, you are like with this Athena card here, you know, your superheroic odyssey is admired, right? So I feel you are going to be pretty strong. Maybe you're going to be a little resistant, I feel. You know, you might be a little resistant also to any connection coming in. Because, you know, with this tidy house, clarity in organization, I think you have everything set, you know, in your life. You would have had everything set in your life, and then this person comes up and, you know, you are not even, I think, looking for this connection. For some of you, I'm getting, you might even be going through some sort of a heartbreak or something like that. So I think, you know, this is how I see that, you know, you would be before you meet this person. And when you meet this person, I feel it's going to be like an instant connection here. All right. I feel that with the Six of Cups, that, you know, it's going to be some sort of an instant recognition, instant familiarity, meeting an old friend, that sort of a feeling. All right. Now, how is this connection going to be like? I'm getting like, okay, first of all, I'm getting that this is like both of you are star seeds. Okay, star seed, what lights you up? Now, maybe you have always felt alone in this world. Okay, maybe you always felt lonely, like no one understands you. You are quite accomplished, I feel. But somehow in the area of love, I think it has always been like, you know, it's always been hurtful. You've never come to the same page with anybody, guys, you know. And maybe you had this deep desire to meet someone who's like you, you know, to someone who can understand you, someone who can finish your symphony here, right? And that is the person that you are meeting, right? This person also might be a starseed. They also might be having the similar kind of background as you. You know, they also might not, they might be very accomplished. I feel both of you might be very accomplished people, because this is a number four and this is Athena. It's almost like you guys are like superheroes of some sort. Maybe you are in the public eye because it says your superheroic odyssey is admired. Maybe you've had a life which is, you know, like kind of inspirational or something like that. There's an owl here. So, you know, very wise. You or they might be very wise. There's also a warrior stance here. So you guys are fighters. You've been fighters in your life. But when it comes to your heart, it's always been disappointment, because you just don't find anybody, you know, who fits the bill, right? I mean, it's not the fault of the other people. You just are not on the same page. Okay, and so, you know, you might have felt that, you know, like it's not gonna happen, nothing's gonna happen, all right, in terms of love, right? And this person, I'm feeling, also has a pretty similar sort of a thing, you know, to them. They also might be feeling, you know, kind of left out, not fitting in. They have everything in order with the tidy house, clarity and organization. They have everything in order, but when it comes to, you know, like their heart, it's still aching. I think this person also might have gone through some pretty major heartache or heartbreak in their life when they meet you, I feel, you know. And it's like them meeting you clears that heartache away. Otherwise, this person would have just sat there, you know, just remembering what happened in the past and feeling so lonely and feeling like, kind of, you know, like, what's going to light me up? Maybe I should just float away, float away somewhere in the galaxy. Because you see, with these two cards here, Unfinished Symphony and Starseed, they're almost similar cards, right? This person is like in the air, and, you know, the card is Unfinished Symphony, and the Starseed is looking at the planets and sort of thinking that, you know, what lights you up, that, you know, there's something beyond that lights them up. This person is a very, I think this person's a very, like, different person. I mean, that's the word I'm getting. This is someone, this one is a starseed. I definitely feel that your person is like a very advanced and evolved soul, first of all, right? Because they are coming from another land, they have so much wisdom, they have kind of, you know, like, I think this person might be very well-to-do as well. I'm seeing like this beautiful house, and it says a tidy house, clarity in organization. It's a very methodical sort of an energy, maybe an earth sign, I sense. You know, maybe like a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn kind of thing. This person has built up their life, and it's a pretty solid structure, as you can see. This is also the card number one. So this person is an initiator, self-initiator, self, you know, someone who's a self-starter. They do things by themselves. I mean, I'm seeing a lot of ones here. Somehow this is a one, this is a one. So yeah, there is something about the number one here. So this person, I think, might be quite well-to-do. They might have a beautiful house. I don't know why. That's a very specific thing that I'm getting. They might have a very beautiful place that they live in, right? You know, this one is also a warrior, all right? They are very wise. They are very, you know, like warrior-like people. Your superheroic Odysseus is admired. Maybe this person is also in the public eye or in the government in some very important post or something on those lines, right? But you know, like that's one thing, that's one part of them. I think the earthy part of them is this, right? They are very grounded, very practical, very you know, like in control of things, okay? Very wise as well, right? And then there is this other part of them which is like, you know, very like out of this world. You know, they just feel that you know, they're not living life the way they want it, that there is something missing. Not just because of, you know, they don't have a partner, but there's just this very spiritual or airy sort of quality to this person, because they are most probably a starseed, right? And they just don't fit in. But this one is a very good, like, you know, in their lives, they've done a really good job of settling themselves. All right. But in terms of their, you know, intrinsic soul self, I feel this person is, you know, it just doesn't feel like they belong. And then, of course, in their emotional space, I'm seeing that this person longs for a soulmate connection. And they've been hurt very badly in the past. So this is your person. Now, what is the connection going to be like? I am definitely seeing that the first thing I'm getting here is that this is, you know, like, as you can see, it says your superheroic Odyssey is admired. This connection that both of you will have, it's going to be something that will be noticed, I think. I don't know how. Maybe you guys are going to work together or something, or you're going to be somehow inspirational. I think it's like two superpowers coming together kind of a thing. So it's going to be somehow inspirational. This connection is going to be very inspirational. There's a number four, so it's going to be a very stable connection, something that is going to last a lifetime. This might even be like a soulmate, like a twin flame connection, because it's like four, number four. Four of Wands is generally twin flame, but like that's not exactly, I mean, you don't take the labels as they are. And of course, I'm seeing that, you know, you guys are going to finish each other's this symphony of, you know, of wanting, longing, pining. This is the perfect fit for you. It's almost like the universe kind of planted this person in front of you, because, you know, you guys, both of you required each other to finish the symphony on earth. Right? I mean, it's like there was something missing. Maybe in a past life you guys could not meet or something like that, or even in this life, and then the universe, you know, just gets you back in touch with this person, and you know, your heart is healed. That's what I'm hearing. Your heart is healed, you know. So maybe by yourself you guys were hurting, but with each other there is so much of, you know, beauty coming in. I'm also seeing that This is a number 10 card here, right? So this is like, this is, I don't think you're going to have any other relationships after this one, because this one kind of just fits the bill, right? This one completes your symphony. This one lights you up, right? So I really feel that this is the completion of your quest for love, all right? The other thing I'm seeing about this is, with this card here, clarity and organization, I think you guys are a lot like each other. Both of you would have been accomplished, and you would probably accomplish something, guys. I don't know, with this card and this card, I'm seeing that you guys might build something together. Maybe like a business, a house, or something that gets you noticed, you know, something that gets both of you noticed, you know, for some reason. So it's perhaps you guys will build something together, and that will last a long time. I also feel you guys will have a beautiful place that you live in. Maybe that's what you're going to build, but I'm getting more in terms of something inspirational. All right. How are you guys going to meet? I feel that, you know, I don't know. What is this? This is like, I have a feeling here that this person is just going to come into your life. Like, you know, the way you're going to meet it is, maybe this person's going to come into your life to woo you or something like that. Okay? I mean, like, take it how it resonates. Either you would woo them or they would woo you. There is a sense of wooing here, you know, trying to get to know someone, pleasing someone, impressing someone, you know. So this is how, you know, maybe you or they might be in this Three of Arrows thing. So not very interested in love, very stable in your lives and all that. So this person will have to convince you to be with them. That's what I'm seeing. They will try to organize things. They will move mountains for you, I'm hearing. Okay, this person with this card here, clarity and organization, this person's going to make sure everything is looked after by them, if you come into their lives. All right, they would really want you. Okay, this person feels that you are the one. I don't know why I'm getting this. Okay, because with this, your superheroic odyssey is admired. It's like this person has a sense of admiration for you. Okay, they would. Maybe you guys are in the public eye of some sort or something like that. But this person admires you. They'll woo you. They will try to set up or build things for you. In the course of this connection, I'm also feeling that there will be heartbreaks. Like, it's going to be a very beautiful connection. You'll keep reconnecting back to each other, meaning that, you know, even if there's some hurt or something, it's like you guys can't stay away. Staying away from each other is like this, you know, like just not even wanting to sort of, you know, not even being grounded. Like, you know, what happened? Like, your life is an unfinished symphony if this person is not present. All right. So such a stable connection, most probably your future spouse also, I feel. Okay. But there will be some, heartaches here. There will be, because I think both of you are like super, headstrong type of people, super accomplished people. Okay. And then there is this intensity of love. So there is going to be some ups and downs here. But you will always come back to each other, guys, because you are home to each other. You are home to each other. You can't live without each other. Okay, you are like two pieces of a puzzle, right? The symphony is not finished if you two are not together. I also sense with this card here, the Athena and the Starseed, that you guys have some sort of a mission, like a double mission or something like that. Because both of you are Starseeds, and there is some odyssey that you guys are going to play out once you are together. All right, because here I'm seeing your superheroic odyssey is admired. You're going to accomplish something together, guys. All right, something that was unfinished before, something that maybe in previous lifetimes you guys could not do. This time around, you're going to do it, and people are going to notice this, guys. So this is like soulmates coming back for a life mission as well as to stick around together. Wow, like I talked so much. Oof, is there anything else? There were so many messages I couldn't stop. I'm just trying to figure out, is there anything else? Something about music here, okay? Something about music. Maybe your person would send you answers in music before you meet them, or you would send it to them, vice versa, something like that. When you are feeling like alone, maybe you you would suddenly hear songs and, you know, they would make sense to your current situation. That is your person sending you some sort of telepathic indications that things are going to be fine. All right. So, yeah, guys, this is pretty much what I'm seeing. This is wow. Some different quality about this. I mean, I'm sensing some spiritual sort of connection here. Don't want to label it, but it's a very beautiful feeling. Right, so pile three with the citrine. What is your next relationship going to be like? Pile three, let's see. Atlantis. Atlantis has risen. The awakening begins. Wow, I just had chills. Grace. This is the card number. I think this is the star. Yeah. 17, number 17, the star. This is the knight of the knight of wands. Joyful muse, inspiration. Okay. The crumbling. All right. And the change in the wind. My God, those are similar energies. Gosh. Wow. All right, guys. Pile three. Interesting. What is your next connection going to be like? Okay. So now let's see. I am the very first thing, as you can see, that I am seeing here is... I don't know why I'm getting this with this a change in the wind, Atlantis and the crumbling. This is something big, guys. This is something very big. Your next connection. This is something to do with Atlantis. Now, I'm not sure if you know about it, but a lot of Atlanteans are born in today's world because in today's times, because it is the coming of the new age, the golden age. It is Atlantis being rebuilt again, and there was a contract, you know, at the times of Atlantis before it sunk. There was a promise that the people made that they would come back and rebuild Atlantis at this time, right? I am seeing that maybe you and your person are part of that. All right, so wow. Where did that come from? Okay, because I mean, like, wow, why would we have Atlantis here, right? Atlantis has risen. The awakening begins. This connection is going to be a huge spiritual awakening for you guys, your next connection. All right, perhaps it might push you into your life purpose of whatever you want to do, guys, okay? But it's going to be something big, all right? There is a change in the wind. There are things that are going to be absolutely broken down and changed in your life. Now, whenever that happens, right? This connection is come about to change your life 180 degrees. All right, guys, because I think this connection that is coming to you is going to launch you into your life purpose. All right, you are an Atlantean, and I think your person also might be someone who knows you from there, and you guys are here right now on this planet, you know, to actually create waves of change, because you know, like, you guys are awakened people, and now you want to crumble any kind of foundations, any kind of false structures, you know, because you see here, this is the awakening begins, Atlantis has risen, and this is the crumbling. What are you clinging to? It's almost like, if you look at it, like, this is the first thing I'm getting at. I don't know why, but it's come up, and the change in the wind. You are changing. You guys are going to be change agents for, like, humanity or something. Pretty intense, guys. You're going to be showing people a new horizon, new vista, a much more beautiful one. And, you know, crumbling these things away, the ones that didn't suit. Here also there is a crumbling happening, a change in the wind. This is blowing away, right? And to come to this. Wow, that is amazing. I don't know how many people pick pile 3, because this is the first thing that's coming to me. Anyways, in terms of the connection, what I'm seeing is that this is a connection that is going to make, it is going to it requires you to make very major changes in your life. If you are in connections that are not serving you, you'll have to walk away. If you are in professions or circumstances, and you know, whatever it is that is not suiting you, this connection, the coming of this connection, is going to require you to shed all that. Perhaps you might even be in that position at that time. Maybe you have already sort of, you know, shed all these uncomfortable or things that are not for your highest good. Perhaps you've already shed them, right? And then this person appears, right? I mean, take it how it resonates. It could be both ways, right? But I am sensing with the Princess of Wands, the King, the Knight of Wands here, you know, this person is going to come very suddenly into your life, all right? In a very fiery way, okay? And it's going to cause some sort of an awakening. All right. Now, I'm also getting that the way you guys are going to meet is like, you know, it's going to be during some major change. All right. That's what I'm getting. Maybe, you know, it could be a good change or a bad change. But if I see all of this here, it's almost like a new you is emerging. All right. After something died, you know, some old structure died, a new and more brilliant you emerges. That is when this person, you know, sees you as a muse and rushes forward, all right? And then there is peace, because this is the Star, wish fulfillment. This is a connection which is like your wish fulfillment, but we'll go, you know, like, step by step. How are you going to meet this person? I feel during change, or immediately after change, this is the person who's going to be, you know, like, they are going to chase you, all right? They're not going to let you go. No, you are a muse for this person, right? The number 33 is also adding up to a 6, which is a number of love, right? Joyful muse, inspiration. This person with the Knight of Wands and this joyful muse card here, they might even, like, you know, I don't know, like, wine and dine you, sing to you, or play music for you. I don't know. This person is not going to let you go, because they want to take care of you. They want to give you, you know, your wish fulfillment, right? They want you to rest, basically. They are going to be doing all the work, okay? In this next relationship, you know, whoever you connect with, this person you connect with is the one who's going to go for you. All right. And once you accept, all of this change is going to happen. All right. Now, when I look at it, how is this person going to be like? I'm sensing this is a person who has made huge changes in their own lives. All right, they are people who are very fiery, very passionate people. The chemistry in this connection is going to be mind-blowing. The chemistry and the healing. All right. So I feel that this person is someone who is very vibrant. Okay, that's the word I'm getting. Vibrant. They don't mind breaking down old structures to bring in something newer and better. Okay, this is a very transformational person. They're not scared, you know, of trying new things. They're very, very passionate people, fiery people. I'm getting the fire signs here. I'm getting Aries, Leo, Sagittarius here. A lot of fire energy. And there is a sense here in your person that, you know, everything will be looked after. A very positive person, I must say. I'm getting that sort of, you know, like vibe from it. This person might paint or sing or, you know, play some sort of musical instrument. They're a joy to be around with. I mean, this is a person who can, you know, like when they walk into a room, people have to look at this person. Because they have acquired so much of intense, beautiful energy within themselves because of all these transformations they have gone through and come out the other end peaceful. This is a person who doesn't, you know, like they are not people who will dilly-dally too much, okay, about going for what they want. They want you, they'll get you. That's what I feel, okay. Now, I also feel this person has a higher purpose here, okay. They might be light workers, they might be healers, spiritual people. You know, they want to bring some sort of peace to the world, some sort of, you know, safety, a feeling of calm to the world. They might be in, you know, professions of, like I said, the artist or painter or singer or dancer, something like that, okay? But this person wants to affect the world on a large scale. So this could be a person who has a high position or aspires to have a high position, something on those lines. They might even be like, you know, I don't know, I'm getting this as a very specific message. There might be a rags to riches story here. Okay, someone who's kind of built themselves up from the ground. And so this person is unfazed when it comes to, you know, grabbing the things they love. Okay, this person is very vivacious. They might be having a good sense of humor. Okay, but mainly in this connection, this person is going to look after you so well, guys, right? This is a person who, yeah, they have all this fieriness, but at the end of the day, you know, there is also a lot of calm. It's like, you know, like they lift you out of your the burdens, and almost like an angel, you know, like someone who's a rescuer. Blessing, you know, like as a wish fulfillment, someone you can rest with, you know, someone who will protect you. That's what I'm getting, right? Someone who will protect your heart from whatever intensities you guys have gone through. Maybe you guys are the ones who have gone through a lot of turbulence in this connection or in previous connections. This one is someone who's going to bring calm to your heart, okay, is somebody who is going to look after you, all right? There is also a sense of joy and, you know, vivacity. This person will make you amuse. I think they are fascinated by you. Something about you fascinates this person. All right. And they are not letting you go. There is a lot of passion here. The fire here with the Knight of Wands here. I mean, there's going to be a lot of passion. The chemistry and the physical intimacy part of this, you know, of this connection is going to be great. All right. This is a person who is also quite interested in the physical aspect of, you know, relationships. Now, when it comes to the connection itself, I am sensing that, you know, it's going to be a very fiery and a very, like, you know, something life-changing. This person is someone life-changing. Now, obviously, we don't know where it's going to end up, all right, but I am seeing like there might be a trend here of multiple breakups and then once again, you know, like rebuilding, breakup, rebuilding. There's going to be quite a few you know, breaking downs here, you know, because there are certain things that you guys need to share, both of you, not just them, both of you, because you know there is a change in the wind. It's time that you started looking at connections in a different way, and it's time they did as well. All right, it's there might be a feeling of like instant gratification for some of you. I feel for some of you it might be like, you know, this person comes and goes away, right? Because Knight of Wands is somebody who's just looking for like a hookup or something. For some of you this could be like a hookup. I feel, you know, a lot of fire, passion, admiration, this and that, and then boom, you know, it breaks down, right? But again it rises up, right? So if you want it, right? So it depends, because there is a sort of player quality to this person. You know, if that is for some of you. For some of you, I feel this person might be like a player. But for others of you, I'm seeing that this person is someone who's very convinced about you. All right. I feel that if this person is a player, then the universe is going to save you by making this end abruptly. All right. This is a message coming through for some of you, because it's the next connection, right? So we don't know. So the universe will save you if this person doesn't have the right intentions, okay? But if this person has the right intentions, this can be a very transformative relationship for you and for them. This is also wish fulfillment. This person is someone whom you can rely on and depend on, all right? Even when, you know, like things are very tough, like it's almost like, you know, this is fire and she's sleeping, so it's almost like you can sleep even when the room is on fire, because you know that you can rely on this person. That's how intense this person can be. That's how amazing this person can be. All right, so yeah, I'm getting that these two scenarios in this thing, you know, one that it might not really be someone who has a long-term view, and for others it's like this is someone who is very reliable. However, with this relationship there are going to be number of changes. Perhaps for some of you, you might have to relocate because of this person, you might have to change jobs because of them, you might have to change yourself in some way, your family, your background, I don't know, like there are going to be huge changes when this person comes in. And when this person comes in, they're going to come in fast. I'm also seeing that they're going to be a lot of very wonderful, joyful moments that you both will enjoy, right? It's like both of you inspire each other, right? There's something about them that inspires you. There's something about you that inspires them. And you know, like it's just going to be a very beautiful life with this person, because you guys are constantly creating, you know, constantly experimenting, creating, innovating, shedding, you know, rebuilding. I don't know, there's just something beautiful about this connection. It's so vibrant and vivacious. Like you cannot just, you know, like be bored in this connection. Yes, there will be times of utter peace and healing as well. But mostly I'm seeing a lot happening in this connection. I don't know, maybe spur of the moment travel, vacations, and I don't know, like I'm seeing a lot here, guys. But at the end of the day, you do have you know, a shoulder to back, you know, to cry on, someone there who has your back, right? It's going to cause a lot of healing, guys. I'm seeing that, you know, any kind of traumas that you guys have gone through, because I do see that for you guys, heartbreaks that you've gone through, this person is coming to heal your heart, all right? Because this person is holding a heart. There's going to be a lot of emotional healing, emotional and spiritual healing that is going to take place for those of you who are hurt. I'm also seeing that this is something like a wish fulfillment, all right, for you guys. Okay, What else do I see? Yeah, I do feel that this person, might try to impress you a little bit with this, but mainly they are coming at you. All right. And with these cards, there's something very spiritual about this connection. I don't know, guys, like there is a life purpose here that I can see. All right. If this connection works, if you guys make it, with all these changes and all that you guys have to go through, if you guys make it, then you are here. I mean, then you would have passed all the tests for couples, I guess. Okay. And then you start affecting the, people around you, the world in some way. Inspiration. You guys are kind of meant to be some sort of inspiration here. Okay. So I don't know. Maybe you guys are going to be like tested or something like that before, you can come up to this task, whatever it is. Because we have Atlantis here. I cannot ignore this. There is just something about it. Maybe this connection is going to be like Atlantis as well. Because, if you know the story of Atlantis, it's like people misused the power they had. And that's why it sunk. So, with all this abundance that you guys have, if there is any of you that misuses this connection or doesn't sort of, or acts manipulative, then, it all goes boom. You have to come into your true authentic self in this connection. All right. So this is coming for you guys, and it is big, and it's going to be sudden. It's going to change a lot in your life, guys. So be ready. This is what I'm seeing. Okay. Bye.